Shit, let me see. Y'all can see me? Alright.
This is my background music, cause I don't wanna get copyrighted. So I made motion to this beat, kinda land low key, but join the team. Subscribe, subscribe.
What is up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel. I'm Deja. Hello. Coming to you looking like Rufus, but it's all good in the hood because it's, day is it? It's a Thursday, so it's okay. And we in quarantine. Still. Oh my God, we're still in quarantine. I'm gonna still be in the house though if they open up Vegas, because that means everybody's gonna come out here. Right now, I feel like I'm just rambling. But today, I'm gonna be telling you guys a story time on how, you know, I almost got evicted from my apartment. Wonderful. My voice? Am I losing my voice? Yeah, I almost got kicked out of my apartment. And I honestly have a voice message to prove it. So I'm gonna just play that right now, then I'm gonna go ahead and tell y'all the story.
Hey Deja, this is me. I'm calling from the leasing office. This is the community manager. Mm-hmm. I wanted to talk to you in regards to an incident that happened last night. So if you can give me a call back as soon as you can. 702.
Okay, yeah. So that was the message I received on the day of, what day was that? April 16th, a long time ago, okay, we're past it. It was a misunderstanding, the whole shebang. Was it really though? So let me just give you guys a little backstory on me or whatever. I've been living on my own since I would say 17. I was by myself, not with my family, but I was with my, son's dad's family. Like, I lived with him my senior year of high school, and then we both moved into our own apartment together when I was 18. He was like 19. So that's that. I've been living on my own since I was like 18. I'm getting ready to be 23 in August 19th, Leo season, if y'all just wanted to know. Been living on my own since I was 18, and this is like the first time any of this has ever happened to me. So let me just jump right into the story, because I'm pretty sure y'all have a lot to do. Not really though, we're in quarantine. One day, it's like I'm telling you guys a bedtime story. One day, I had friends come over from out of state. You know, we're all just chilling, enjoying our day, you know, enjoying our time. We cooked, drank a little bit of this and that. You know, like, we're all just sitting here playing games, and I know that my pool, like our complex pool, closes. Well, you're not supposed to be in it after 12 a.m. So it was like 11-ish at this time. Nowhere near 12, okay? I think it was like 10-ish, 11. I was not aware that our pool was like, you can't get in it, okay? Like, I was aware that our like gym and like the little hangout spot in the office and coffee room, all that great stuff, was closed, because they don't want anybody in like the main office because corona. So I was unaware that our pool was closed. There's no signs. So I was just telling my friends, like, you know what, let's go see if the jacuzzi is heated up. We can like get in the jacuzzi, put our feet in, just chill, hang out. And you know, so we decided to go down to the pool. My little pot thing wasn't working, and the side of the gate that we went to get into the pool, sometimes the doors be messing up on that side of the pool. So I just figured, you know, my little pot thing's not working. And one of my friends was like, I'ma just hop the fence. So he hopped the gate and let us in. So, you know, we're all in the pool area, chilling. The jacuzzi was cold, because you know, it's not heated up because we're not supposed to be in it. I didn't know that until I got the message. We're in the pool by the jacuzzi, and it was cold, so you know, we're just sitting down chilling, talking, and then one of my friends decided it was a good idea to go skinny dipping. So the man hopped in the pool. He literally was butt naked, hopped in the pool. I really wish I could show you guys the videos, because it's so funny. There's apartment buildings facing the pool or whatever. That's how it is every apartment complex. I made sure we weren't loud, but at this point I was a little lit, so I wasn't sure how loud we actually were. And when I do get a little lit, I go up here. Like, that's how you could tell if I am lit, because I'm actually really loud. Just making sure we weren't that loud, because I have a respect and I'm very aware of people wanting to sleep or whatever. But you know, like, we ain't got nothing to do, it's corona. And then somehow one of my friends ended up in the pool with all the clothes on, and then they pushed me in the pool. They had to run and get me because I sprinted. I didn't sprint fast enough, but I tried. And then, you know, they threw me in the pool, and then somebody's phone got thrown in the pool, so they had to get in the pool to get the phone. It was just a lot, okay? Like, it was fun. Like, we were just all literally just chilling, enjoying our lives. Like, we're young, we're enjoying our lives. So then, you know, the next morning comes around. We're all just sitting down. Actually, we're playing Cards Against Humanity, and my phone gets a ring, and I have my building's number saved in my phone as my apartment complex. So I'm like, hold on a minute, why are they calling me? And I'm like, hold on a minute, they only calling me because they found out about last night. Like, my friends were like, no, they didn't. There's no way. I knew we had cameras in our complex, but I was really unaware at the fact that they had cameras pointing towards the pools. Like, where would they be? I don't know. So I was really unaware that, you know, we were being filmed. They saw that man skinny dipping. Totally unaware. When I look back at it, like, it's all fun and games. It was all really fun. It was all really just a miscommunication. I'm gonna just tell you guys what the lady said. I answered the phone. Okay, look, let me get back to that. I'm all over the place. I apologize. I do answer the phone, okay? And I answer it until I thought about, oh my God, they know about last night. So I answered it. I said hello. Nobody said nothing. So I hung up. And I was like, oh my God, they know about last night. And then I say about like 3 minutes later, they call me back and I didn't answer because I wanted to see if they were to leave a voice message and what the voice message was gonna say. And then that was a voice message. So the voice message basically said like, hey, this is the property manager. Come call me back so we can discuss the incident that happened last night. And when she said last night, I said, oh Lord, they know about the pool. So me and my friends are all like, oh, beat, what we gonna say, what we gonna do? So I was like, you know what? What can they say, honestly? Like, what can they say? I'm grown. You are not my mom or my dad. Like, what? Why am I scared right now? Called back or whatever, and I was like, hey, can I talk to so-and-so, the lady who called me? I asked directly for her. And I was like, hey, can I talk to so-and-so? This is Deja. And she was like, okay, yeah, hold on. Let me put her on the phone. So the lady, property manager, comes, talks to me. I'm like, hey, so-and-so, this is Deja. I just got your voice message. Like, do you wanted to discuss something? Like, what's up? And she's like, hey Deja, you know, I've gotten a lot of calls for, what did she say? What's the word she used? This happened like a month ago. What did she say? She was like, I got a couple noise complaints last night at like somebody was in the pool area. And you know, like, I'm not sure if you're aware, but the pool is closed because of Corona. We got a lot of complaints because they already feel like, this is her word, y'all. This is her word. We already got a lot of complaints because everyone in the building kind of doesn't feel like we're doing what we need to do to keep everyone safe because this time of quarantine and Corona. And I'm like, oh, okay, like, I'm sorry, but I was really unaware that, you know, the pool was closed and da da da. And at this point, I knew she had cameras. I put her on mute, you know, when you put somebody on mute and you talk to the people around you. So put her on mute, and me and my friends were like, bro, they got cameras, like, they seen us, da 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 da. So she was like, yeah, I was just calling, like, can you explain to me, like, what happened? And I was like, bitch, you know what happened. Like, you got cameras, you've seen what happened. I'm like, yeah, I'm sorry. Like, I was so unaware that, you know, we weren't supposed to be in the pool area. Like, there's no signs. There's not. But there's signs on the office area saying, like, nobody can come in and blah, blah, blah. So why not put signs on the pool? Anywho, I'm like, you know, like, I wasn't aware. And she's like, well, like, how did you get in? I'm like, what you mean? What you mean I got in? I was like, you know what? Actually, I tried to use my little pod thing, but it wasn't working. She was like, yeah, we turned the knobs off. And I was like, well, yeah, I didn't know that. Like, I just figured that the gate wasn't working because, you know, I was like, because you know that side of the gate has problems. And she was like, yeah, I know, but like, how did you get in? And I was like, hey, like, I'm not about to lie to you because at this point, y'all got cameras. So I was like, you know, like, my friend hopped the gate. And she was like, well, like, why? And I was like, yeah, well, you know, like, we just wanted to get in the jacuzzi. I just figured your pods wasn't working. And she was like, well, yeah, I can understand where you're coming from. Like, I've seen on the cameras, you guys are just trying to have fun, all this other stuff. And she was like, but you know, the pool closes at 12. I was like, girl, we wasn't there at 12. I was like, we weren't there at 12. And I know we wasn't there at 12 because I recorded Snapchats. And when they save to your camera roll, it tell you what time exactly and what place you was at when you took the Snapchat. So I was like, you know what? I wasn't there at 12. I was fully aware that the pool closes at 12, and I made sure we weren't there at 12, miss. So continue with the next lie. Okay, like, we wrapped it up. We talked. She was like, yeah, girl, like, it's okay. I understand you guys are just trying to have fun. Just don't let it happen again, because you know we are doing quarantine and you know corona blah blah blah, and they already feel like we're not doing what we need to do to keep the community safe. And I'm like, girl, you ain't gotta worry about me. Like, I ain't getting in the pool no more until you say I can get in the pool. Like, I got you. We talked about that, and at this point we're fine. She's like, and I do see that you renewed your lease, and I would just hate to have to terminate that. And in my head I was like, girl, honestly, I really wouldn't care, because like I was looking to move because I know like my lease is up. I like my complex or whatever. I like my apartment, like I really do. The people here are so nice, like that's why I renewed my lease, like I'm staying here. But majority of the reason why I renewed my lease is because I hate moving. Like, I don't want to have to move all this stuff out of my apartment. So I said, you know what, I'm gonna just live here for another year. That's really why I renewed my lease. Tell her, I was like, yeah, like, honestly, you know, you do what you gotta do at this point. But I was like, you know, like, it won't happen again. We're cool, we're chilling. You ain't even gotta bring all that up, girl. Like, why are you trying to threaten me? I'm not scared. Basically, she was telling me she would hate to have to evict me, and girl, bye. So yeah, that's the story on how corona almost got me evicted, and I don't appreciate it. Me and my friends just want to have fun. Anyways, is my voice annoying? I feel like my voice is so annoying. And you know what? A lot of people have told me my voice is annoying. That's okay though. All right, you guys, that will conclude the video. If you enjoyed it, make sure you give it a big thumbs up. If you made it this far and you're not yet subscribed, what? Make sure you hit that subscribe button, bitch. And on that note, make sure y'all stay in the house, stay safe. Take vitamin C, drink your orange juice, take your medicines, your daily vitamins, you need to take them. Just stay in the house. I've seen that a lot of states have like lifted their like stay at home orders or whatever. And y'all been going crazy. I don't care if Vegas says, oh, we're free to go outside. You know where I'm not going? Outside. Because you know why? Everybody and their grandfathers are gonna be outside. And guess what? Corona's not just gonna go away because somebody said, oh, outside is open. So, you know, make sure you stay safe. Keep practicing all the measurements we have taken this far to stay safe. Even if they do say you can go outside, social distancing, you know? Anyways, I'ma just go. Love you guys. Bye.